Hey guys, Jim Chester coming to you live once again. We are out here in East Brunswick, New Jersey, coming at you from the Genesis Pediatric Conference. And I have Adonis Alejandro. What a mouthful, the double A.
Yeah.
And you came out here to support this program, pediatrics and chiropractic. Give us some of your takeaways from the weekend.
We had some amazing speakers. Top of the list, I would say, would be Dr. Carrick. And it kind of, you know, challenged us, all us doctors, to up our game. And, you know, the average doctor actually loses his skill set after, you know, 10 to 20 years. So just like anything else, you always have to grind and improve your skill set. That really helped me out, as well as reconnecting with all these awesome doctors and just having some of the, knowledge bombs that just come out naturally. Just being with a, you know, such an elite group of doctors.
And did you find it valuable, the selection process that they had with the vendors here?
Well, yeah, the vendors were bar none the best. I mean, I know we talked some business on the side, and as well as, you know, local gold. Probably gonna do some work with them. So yes, there's a lot of vendors here that can actually up your game with your practice.
So that's just it, is that Stu and Terry did a distillation process and found the best of the best in the chiropractic industry. They invited them out here to share with their audience. The audience was amazing. The speakers were amazing. The food was amazing. And now let's say a couple of cool things about Stu and Terry for what they do for the chiropractic community.
Well, I met Stu and Terry, I guess, actually as a student. So that would have been over 2 decades ago. So we actually took a beat-up van from Life University up from Atlanta, and we went to their practice, and they welcomed us with arms open and actually did like a whole little weekend seminar, like haphazardly. And they're still doing it, and obviously they upped their game by having a big pediatric conference. So, I mean, they are always innovating and on the cutting edge with pediatric chiropractic.
And that's a good question for me, too. Why is it so important to make sure that we can adjust kids, man?
The reason being is, you know, kids are the next generation. They're next generation on deck. So I think, and that's actually another thing that I got from Dr. Pete, was our responsibility to our community and our accountability is to the next generation, our kids. So are we actually giving them a step up, or are we giving them a disadvantage, a step down? And that, you know, I took that as a challenge, which a lot of our colleagues, I think, took it too. So that's one more reason why you got to up your game.
Yeah, you know, it's so important for us to, you know, be like-minded, but it's also important for us to pay attention and future cast and look out the next generation. And we want to raise healthy children. And I know that there's not one mom or dad out there that says, I wish my kids were more sick.
Yeah.
But honestly, they just don't have solution-based ideas. And why is chiropractic the proper solution for them?
In my belief, the reason why chiropractic's a good platform to jump off to gain other tools, is because the premise. I mean, it's the baseline of, you know, the power that made the body heals the body. I mean, obviously there's limitations of matter, but it's more like, you know, like Gary Vee says, you know, you got the dirt, you got the micro game, and then you got the sky, you got the, you know, you got the macro game. So those day-to-day decisions are going to stack up and actually result in, you know, what a parent can do for their child. And that's what's going to lead to the next LeBron or the next, you know, President Obama, or, you know, that next big person who's going to make that change and make that big dent in the universe.
Exactly. And, you know, I love how granular you get, but how big idea you get as well. And I know one of the things that you're really passionate about is this thing that you call hybrid coaching. Mm-hmm. Let's tell our audience a little bit about hybrid coaching.
Well, in practice, I was starting to see, like in the early 2000s, I was starting to see patients come in over and over again. And a lot of the challenges that they were experiencing was because of lifestyle. So not what they were doing in my practice or in the clinic, but what they were doing outside. So most of the time when you ask people if they need to lose weight or what they can do to improve their lives, they always have some sort of excuse, you know. And, you know, in our practice, being from Jersey, you know, so we're pretty upfront. So basically, there's no excuse. You just got to do the work. And one of those works is educating and giving clients or patients tools to start creating the right decisions, which after a while, we go into the micro macro, that'll turn into solid habits. Mm-hmm. And most of our that leads into, you know, our, you know, conventions this weekend is most children learn not by what you say, but what you do. So I've taught my son this, is that, you know, it's, you know, don't listen to what I say, listen to my actions. And
absolutely,
that's what habits are all about. So in our program, we've broken it down to four distinct areas where most people or patients have challenges. The first and baseline is basically your nutrition. I mean, are you giving your body the right resources so it can live up to its potential? Are you optimizing?
Mm-hmm.
So that falls into meal prep and the quality of food and the quantity of food. You know, too little is not enough. Too much is can't be a glutton. Second would be your movement program. Okay, you can, you know, get adjusted every day of the week, but if you don't have the muscles to support that structure, then you're just going to degenerate. So what does that look like? And it's more about consistency over intensity, and doesn't matter where you're at. You can do it at home. You can do it in office. If you have 10 minutes, you can get it done. So 10 minutes a day adds up to basically, you know, 70 minutes a week, and that's all the body needs. Okay, and there's some strategies. Third is accountability and time management. There's no excuse. If everyone has the same 24 hours, the same 7 days a week, you know, the difference between you know, President Trump or, you know, NFL quarterback is the work that they put in and how they manage that. And last but not least is self-care and injury management. And that's where, obviously, as chiropractors, where we come in and our philosophy. You know, you could either play the long game or the short game. And I believe, you know, a lot of times if you're reaching for, you know, those drugs for your first option, or maybe you're stuck on a procedure versus the principles of allowing your body, enabling your body to heal itself and recover, is very important. And then obviously the self-care part comes is, you know, what they were saying is, who's smarter? The person that gets you better after a problem happens, or who gets you better before a problem happens? So that's basically it. So we actually can personalize all those, you know, categories to leverage your time and your life to get the most and live well, you know?
You know, some of the things that you're saying there is repetition and patterns.
Mm-hmm.
And if we don't do the right thing, we're doing the wrong thing. And if we're not doing the right thing, the vice versa, we're doing the wrong things. And I think that so many times we get so soft with each other that we're like, oh, you had a bad day, just go do the wrong thing. Or, hey, I had a rough day or a rough week, I'm just going to go do the wrong thing. But really, we have to come into this zone of personal accountability, and we have to look after each other. And if we really do care about ourselves and other people, we just have to, like, check each other. And that's one of the things in the title of this is no excuses.
Yeah.
Like, quit, like, chirping at yourself in your head and letting your head win the game, and quit letting your ambition start to fall to the wayside, and stop, you know, practicing the things that you know that matter to you the most. Just make time for it. Like you said, you need 70 hours a week to practice a healthy lifestyle. You know, you got to eat right. You got to get some vegetables in your life. Drink some green juice. I don't know. But you got to, like, start doing,
exactly,
like, these basic building blocks to make a good human. And that's the thing is why chiropractic is so effective, is because it actually makes a better human. And I think that when people think about chiropractic, like, oh, we need it just for this or we need it for that. No, you need it for quality of life. And I think that sometimes we forget how important it is to invest in ourselves.
Yeah.
Like, we're so far gone from, like, understanding that, like, money is value. But investing in ourselves is where your money should go first. And most people are just hand to mouth, and they're not making it enough to even, like, take care of a quality of life. So why are they going to say, hey, I'm going to take an extra whatever it costs to go see a chiropractor and take care of something that's not a concern to me? But really the concern is that it's prevention, it's care, and it's, like, awareness. And I think that our prevention, our care, and awareness scale is, like, we're zeroed out, bro. So we need to start being no excuses and do the work type mentality and be accountable for each other and look out for each other. And I think once we come to that baseline, we'll realize that we can really make an impact not only with ourselves, but you're your own leader. And if you've got a family and you're, like, not taking care of yourself, what kind of message, like you said, is that sending to your kids?
Exactly. I mean, it's the poor man's mentality versus the rich man's mentality. The thing is when it's all said and done, you know, where are you going to get your ROI at? You know, money's good and everything like that, but it's all about options. So if you have have the resources, and all it is time. So if you have time to, you know, if you have time to go sit on the TV and watch your TV show, then you have time to invest in yourself and in your health. And investing in yourself will actually improve everyone's life around you. And that's the thing that most people are missing, because when you limit yourselves by your perspective of lack of options, you got options all around you, you know?
And it's like what Sigafoos would say also. Why would you come here to get healthy and leave the rest of your family home to be sick?
Exactly.
And I think that when we think about that as a team, and you are the team of your family, so why would you go get fit and leave the rest of your family home to sit on the couch? Why wouldn't we become advocates of each other and create this healthy lifestyle that we all can be a part of, and we can all have more joy and less, you know, distractions? And, you know, life just improves when we start thinking about what can we do together. So I love the idea of getting the whole family adjusted, working from the kids all the way up, cradle to grave care.
Exactly.
And I know we're coming up on the edge of our interview together. Is there anything I didn't ask you that you'd like to share with our audience today?
Yes. Well, basically, you guys can find tips like this. And actually, the thing is we all have to work together. You know, so what I would say is I have a Facebook group, Ask Dr. Adonis, and there's a lot of good information there. So you guys can look me up on Facebook. We have our website on the way. But the most important thing is, do it now. Time is your only asset, and it's actually an asset that's deteriorating every year, every minute.
And it's the one thing that keeps us all balanced out. We all get 24 hours a day, so you can choose to do with that what you like. And go check out Dr. Adonis's page. I'm going to close out. If you guys are looking to upgrade your digital curb appeal or your digital footprint, reach out to Natalie. Schedule Natalie.com. She's with Local Gold, localgold.com. They're USA's digital marketing company, number one digital marketing company for chiropractors. Work with them. We trust them. They're part of our sponsorship flag. Also, if you haven't heard about Cairo Hustle, come over to CairoHustle.com. Take a test drive of episode 100 and subscribe to us on iTunes and Spotify. And just want to say we love and appreciate every single one of you guys. It's been a fantastic weekend out here in at Chiropractic Pediatric Conference out here with Stu and Teresa Warner. And I'm going to close out by saying you guys are just one story away. Keep hustling. We'll see you guys in the next one.